y'all, what's going on, and welcome to Wild Blue. So what we got here for you today is a few news stories. If y'all have been following the news for the past week and a half or so, y'all have probably seen something about these monoliths going around. Yep, the first one was seen in southern Utah, out in the middle of nowhere. You had some guys flying around surveying the land in a helicopter and just happened to see this thing reflected in the sun. The first monolith that was found there in Utah was about 10 feet tall, maybe a little bit taller. It was made out of aluminum or some sort of metal. It had three sides to it. Almost looked like something out of the Space Odyssey movie, if you're familiar with that. Or if you're not familiar with that, maybe y'all have seen Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, the movie from 2005. It had made an appearance in there as well. Anyway, this just turned out to be the first of a number of these monoliths that have appeared. Some have appeared, some have then gone on to disappear. We're just gonna go through a few of them, because they just keep showing up. And I don't know where they're coming from, and you know, some of them are disappearing, I don't know where they're going. So the first one was sighted November 18th, remote area in southern Utah. Based on satellite imagery, they determined it was placed there sometime between August of 2015 and October of 2016. 9 days after it was discovered, it was then found removed. A few mountain bikers or something came by and dismantled it. They took it away because they thought people was tearing up the land. The next one to have appeared was on November 27th in Romania. This one was very similar to the one there in Utah. You had another one on December 2nd in Pine Mountain, California. Had another one on December 3rd in Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania. December 6th, you had the Netherlands and the Isle of Wight. December 7th, you had Albuquerque, New Mexico. You had Dartmoor National Park in southern England. Turns out there's, I think, four now that have been found in England. And you had another one in Warsaw, Poland. And you know what? There may even be more of them. But yeah, the one in Utah doesn't seem to have been anything out of the ordinary as far as its construction. You know, these mountain bikers came by and they just dismantled it without any sort of tools, from what I understand. There's a short video of them taking it down and hauling it off. And it seems to be just some sort of three-sided structure that they took apart by hand, and you know, they just didn't want to see people tearing up the land. You know, all these Garkers were coming in by the hundreds, you know, traveling through here, leaving trash and all kinds of crud behind. No respect for the beautiful nature around them. You know, these mountain bikers, they just weren't standing for that, so they just took it down. Now, I don't think there's anything too out of the ordinary with this whole deal. People want to say it's aliens or time travelers or something like that. It's interesting and all, but with the way those guys were taking that one down in Utah, it ain't no unknown, indestructible alloy or anything like that. It's pretty well within the means of human construction and capability. And the one in Romania was supposedly put up by some welder. He took it down after a day, or someone took it down. And the one in Pennsylvania, it was just some guy putting up one in front of his candy store as some sort of publicity stunt. No, it's interesting because there's so many of them. Maybe it's some kind of social experiment art project, I don't know. But I am fairly certain it ain't aliens. You know, there's no UFO signs associated with it, no people with like radiation burns and no time loss, and at least that I'm aware of. But you know, maybe there is, and you know, if y'all have any other information or any stories about people who have come across these things and suffered some sort of consequence or some sort of UFO sighting associated with it, send an email to wildbluetvstories@gmail.com and we'll follow up with you and see if there's any more to this story. But overall, with all these things coming up all over the world, is there some sort of coordination to it? Is it just some sort of fad going around putting these things up? Or is it some sort of distraction by the government of some kind, or some sort of actors that are working behind the scenes to keep us focused on something that's going on in the world that's much more important? I don't know. It remains to be seen, and we'll follow up on if anything else comes up. Next story here that we've got is a UFO sighting in Yorkshire in England. Police officer saw something strange from his patrol car. It was a number of lights, you know, kind of a cluster of them all moving around, growing dimmer and growing brighter. And they just kind of hovered there as he was driving around in the countryside. He caught a video of it on his dash cam. some very grainy, potato-y looking footage there. They probably don't update their cameras very often, so there ain't much to see. I guess the actual sign was a lot more interesting for this police officer to have seen. But my whole thing is, you know, this thing's just sitting there. It ain't zigzagging around. It ain't flying at these crazy hypersonic speeds anywhere. It's just sitting there. And you know, there's plenty of things that can do what this little deal's doing in this video. You know, it could be a helicopter, could be a drone, could be some kind of weather balloon. There's plenty other options you have before jumping to some sort of alien spacecraft. So I'm not too convinced. Last story here, it turns out President Obama, before he left office, he was briefed on the UFOs that were sighted by the Navy, those ones that came out several years ago. So there may be something to this story, which makes me think this is the biggest story probably of the week to come out. It's that the President of the United States, the leader of the free world, was briefed on this. And you know, they don't just bring anything to the President's desk for him to have a look at. So this tells me there's something to this. And I think the fact that this has been going on for 3 years now, slowly leaking out information about, you know, the signs that have been going on by our military members, tells me that this is a real deal we've got here. We got these things flying around at crazy speeds, the opposite of what the guys saw there in Yorkshire, and that no one knows what these things are. They are true UFOs. Whether they're alien technology or they're something else, we just don't know. So anyway, that's it for the top three news stories of this week. And we'll follow up again next week and see where these stories go and what news stories we have available to us. So if y'all have anything y'all want to share with us, send it again to wildbluetvstories@gmail.com. Check out our Facebook page and check out our website. And last of all, if you like what you see here at Wild Blue, like and subscribe and click the notification button. And we'll have more coming towards you. That said, Wild Blue out.